It's Sybil Wilkes with What You Need to Know. Today is Tuesday, August 4th, 2020. Happy birthday, Mr. President. Number one, primary elections are taking place in five states today: Arizona, Kansas, Michigan, Missouri, and Washington. All states don't have the face mask mandates, but the use of masks encouraged. Most, if not all, counties have been provided PPE kits, plexiglass shields, disposable stylus pens, and social distancing or physical distancing floor markers to use at polling places. Number two, newly implemented procedures at the U.S. Postal Service have led to the nationwide delays of mail delivery. These delays could have detrimental effects on the November election, according to the post office union leader. New procedures, including route changes and the elimination of work hours, were rolled out in early July by the new Postmaster General, Louis DeJoy, a longtime Donald Trump supporter and fundraiser. Number three, Georgia teen Justin Hunter lost both his parents to coronavirus within a week. He's urging others to practice safety protocols. The Atlanta team football player said that he and his parents had all tested positive for the coronavirus last month. Although he was asymptomatic, his mother and father struggled to fight the virus, experiencing headaches, fatigue, coughs, and high fevers. Hunter is an only child and will now be staying with relatives. Number four, under the banner of #WeAreUnited, a letter written by college football players in the Pacific 12 Athletic Conference, or Pac-12, has put another spotlight on college sports during the coronavirus pandemic. Among some of their demands, end racial injustice in college sports and society, COVID-19 protections, including the option not to play during the pandemic, and distribute 50% of each sport's total conference revenue evenly among athletes in their respective sports. Number five, cities with large black populations are spending way too much money on transit law enforcement. While people of color make up the majority of public transit users, national transit systems have never addressed the problems faced by ethnic riders and their communities. Now that the cops are being called into question, riders want law enforcement on the chopping block. Join me today live on YouTube and Facebook at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Central with my friend, the one and only Myra J, as we discuss today's headlines and more. And that's what you need to know. For more information, please go to SybilWilkes.com and sign up for my free newsletter. Be informed, be empowered.